And that's right. Now we are getting to pinpoint weather, and tis the season for hail.
Yeah, but what's the difference between that small dime-sized hail that we typically see to the bigger stuff? Well, other than the damage that it causes, obviously. For more on that, let's get to meteorologist Travis Michels. Hey, Travis.
Well, hey, guys. How are you going? So you know that Dave's been talking about these storms that we've had kind of cruising through the area for the last couple of days and weeks, and that's going to continue as we head through the rest of the spring season. So I wanted to talk about how big that hail can get and also how hail actually forms. So before it actually reaches the ground, we got to dive into this cloud. Now, we have super cooled water droplets that tend to bounce up and down within the clouds, and it's pushed up by updrafts of warmer air. Now, that is a super cooled water droplet. Now, that tends to grab other parts of water droplets, and they kind of become to form a ball, and you can see that they gradually add layers and layers and layers, and then the bigger that hailstone gets, well, that updraft continues to push it up until it becomes too heavy, and it weighs too much, and it beats gravity, and it falls out of the cloud, and that's when we begin to see hail across the eastern plains and, of course, across the Front Range as well. But how big can this hail get? Well, the tiniest that we deal with is about pea size, up to about an inch is the size of a quarter. Then we're talking a hen egg, right around 2 inches, tennis ball 2.5. We saw some about that size about 2 days ago out on the eastern plains. Softball 4 inches. But how normal is this? Well, above an inch, up to a quarter and above, those are the severe levels. So it's pretty common that we get the small pea and penny size stuff. But as we head into the bigger sizes, it's more and more rare. So I know we saw that tennis ball hail out there just about 2 days ago. It's not normal. We make that clear. And pretty cool thing, if you do see hail, you see the little rings within that. That shows you how many times that hailstone has refrozen as it moved through that cloud. With the Pinpoint Weather Team, I'm meteorologist Travis Michels.